warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Student, let recite umur kita Al-Fatihah first before we start our class. Okay. Student, how about the previous lecture? Is it okay? Any question on that? Is it clear?
Yeah, maybe.
Okay, it's good. If you have any question, just ask in a WhatsApp group lah. Okay? Okay, so today I will proceed our lecture, yeah, on the slope stability, which is Bishop and Spencer method. Okay, so before that, you have learned about method of slices, right? Ordinary method of slices. Okay, right. So today, I will explain further on the other method lah, to calculate for factor of safety. Yeah. Right, can you turn on your your camera so that I can see your face?
Okay.
All right. So I will share the slide first. Okay. So I can know your face, or else I cannot ever see you, right? Norman, can you turn off your mic?
All right.
Yeah. Okay. Okay, let me go to the slide presentation. Okay, I think I have uploaded this one in Google Classroom last week, this note. Okay, so today I will explain this one lah. Oops. Okay, so okay, to calculate, let's start our lecture. Eh? So to calculate the slope stability analysis, yeah, to do the slope stability analysis, okay, we have few methods lah listed here. Yeah. So you have learned before in the previous lecture is ordinary method of slices lah. Yeah, the first one. Okay. So today, I will concentrate on the Bishop simplified method, Spencer and Morgenstern Price. Okay. Because this three, yeah. Later on, yeah, when you in I think is fourth semester, fourth year. Yeah, you will take IDP. Yeah, okay, the class. So you will learn about the software. Yeah, to analyze the slope stability, which is slope W lah. Yeah, so in the software, yeah, use this one. This which highlighted in book. Yeah, Bishop, Spencer, and Morgenstern Price lah. Yeah. Because this one, other than that, yeah, the other method is more conservative, the calculation. So that's why the software use these three lah. Yeah. So in this lecture, I concentrate on these three method lah. All right. Okay. All right. Alamak tak. Okay. So in 19, if you have any question, just turn on your mic and ask lah. Alright, feel free to ask. Yeah. Okay. Okay. In 1955, yeah, Bishop proposed a more refined solution to ordinary method of slices. Yeah. So before that, you have learned ordinary method of slices. So now Bishop, yeah, Bishop come out with a more refined solution, yeah, because ordinary method of slices, which you have learned before, yeah, the value of FOS, yeah, factor of safety that you get is more conservative. So that's why Bishop come out with this solution, lah, yeah, more refined solution, yeah. So that's why normally in industry they use this one lah, Bishop refined method. Okay, in this method, yeah, the effect of forces on the side of each slice are accounted for the some degree. Yeah, so if you refer here, yeah, so this is the slices. This is the slice. Yeah, you can see here. Oops. Pen. So this is the slicer. Okay. Yeah. Meaning that when you do the analysis, for example, this is your slope, man. So this is your slope. Okay. So you can divide it into few slices. Yeah. So this is consider one slice lah. All right. So here, the slice, all right? Okay, we can study this method, yeah, by referring to the slope analysis presented in figure, this figure, all right? So the force that act on the n number of slice, yeah, shown in the figure 15.27, so B, so here, yeah, B, okay, have been redrawn, yeah, in a figure A here. Okay. Right. So Bishop simplified method of slices account somewhat for the effect of the force on the side of each slice. Yeah, so this is how the force react on the slice. All right, so it's mentioned here, yeah, ordinary method of slices is too conservative. Yeah, so that's why normally, yeah, in most computer program, yeah, they use Bishop simplified method, yeah, to provide a better result. All right, so far clear, student? Is it okay?
Yes, madam.
Yes, madam.
All right. You can see my slide, right?
Yeah, it's clear.
Yeah,
madam.
Okay, it's good. Okay, so for the TR here, yeah, TR, this one, yeah, TR is equal to this equation. Yeah, so Bishop do the analysis and come out with this equation. All right. Summing forces, yeah, in a vertical direction give here. Yeah. So simplify this one. Yeah. So get NR, yeah, equal to this equation. Yeah. Right. So this is the NR. Okay. Okay, for equilibrium, yeah, of which taking moment about zero give this equation. Okay, and then TR, yeah, the simplified become this equation. Okay. Okay, and then the factor of safety as calculated by Bishop, yeah, method is equal to this one, this equation. Okay, so M alpha here. Yeah, M alpha N. Yeah, so equal to this equation lah. Okay, when you substitute M alpha N into this equation, okay, then you get both side got factor of safety lah. So that's why you need to try to use try and error, yeah, to get the factor of safety. Yeah. So that's why normally they use computer to analyze this one lah. Alright. Okay. So M alpha, yeah. N alpha N, and this one is the friction angle, tangent friction angle over FS. Yeah, so you can use this one to solve this equation lah. Yeah, to get MN and then substitute MM into this equation, then you get FS. Okay, alright. Okay, stability. Okay, now we move to now, and this one, yeah, we have example later on so that you can understand better. All right, stability analysis, yeah, by method of slices for steady state seepage. Yeah, so steady state seepage meaning that you have groundwater lah. Yeah, phytic surface, you have seepage meaning that you have groundwater, yeah, right. You have groundwater. Okay, to account, yeah, for seepage, both the ordinary method of slices and Bishop method of slices must be slightly modified. Yeah, so normally, yeah, in a real in the real world, yeah, of course, yeah. Below the ground, we have groundwater. Yeah. If normally in Malaysia, yeah, we have the groundwater. Yeah. If there's in desert, for example, so it's really dry, maybe you don't have to consider groundwater lah. Yeah. But in here in Malaysia, yeah, we have a lot of rains. Yeah. So we have groundwater lah. Yeah, so that's why if you do the analysis, yeah, you have to consider groundwater. Yeah, I think same goes to your country, kan? Bangladesh is the rainfall, okay? So that's why you have to consider groundwater when you analyze the slope stability. Yeah, okay. Right. So mention here, yeah. Figure 15, this is the figure 15.33, yeah, show the slope through which where the which there is steady state seepage, yeah, so meaning that there's a groundwater. Okay, for n number of slices, yeah, the coverage pore water pressure at the bottom of the slice is equal to un, so equal to this equation lah. Yeah, so un, yeah, the pore water pressure equal to H plus alpha W, gamma W. Yeah. So H is the height of groundwater. Yeah. From the slice, from the slip surface. Sorry, from the slip surface. Yeah. So that is H. H here. Yeah. Let me clean this one. Yeah. So HN, yeah. So HN, yeah, equal to is HN is the height of groundwater, yeah, from the slip plane here. So this is a slip plane, the blue color one, yeah, the blue color. Okay, and then the groundwater line, yeah, the phytic surface, Okay, so the height here, yeah, is a H N. N is the number of slice lah. All right, and gamma W is the density of water, yeah, 9.81. All right, and then the total force caused by pore water pressure at the bottom of the N number of slice is equal to U N, yeah, delta L N. Yeah, so delta ln, yeah, as I'm explained before, is b width of the slices divided by cos alpha. Yeah, this one delta ln. Yeah, if you can memorize, yeah, from the previous. Sorry, my alarm is. My clock is alarming. 12 o'clock already. Like it's been finished first. Anyway. Okay, stop already. Let's proceed our lecture. Okay. So the total force, yeah, caused by pore water pressure, yeah, equal to UN, yeah, delta LN. Yeah, so delta LN, if you can remember from our previous example, yeah, delta LN equal to the width of the slide over cos alpha N. Yeah, this one. I will show you in an example. Yeah. Okay, and then pore water pressure, yeah, must be considered when effective shear strength parameter are used. Yeah, so factor of safety for ordinary method of slices. So this is the equation. Yeah. All right. What you have learned before, yeah, in the previous lecture, the ordinary method of slices. So this is the equation. Okay, and then Bishop simplified the method, yeah, then come out with this equation. So to calculate for the FOS, yeah, factor of safety, using Bishop simplified method, so you have to use this equation. Right? Okay, so we move to example 4. Okay. Okay. Example 4. Eh? Consider the slope, yeah, given in example 3, yeah, ordinary method of slice. In a previous lecture, yeah, example 3. Yeah. However, there are steady state seepage. Yeah, so we can see here, yeah, here, steady state seepage, meaning that there's a groundwater, yeah, fitting line here, okay, and the fitting line shows in the figure 15.34, so this is the figure 15.34, okay, other parameter remaining the same, okay, assume gamma saturated equal to 20.5 kilonewton per meter cube. Determine F, yeah, using equation 15.71. Okay, so to solve this one, so this is the solution. Okay, all right. So you have number of slices. Number one is number of slices. So you have 9 slices lah. Yeah, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 up to 9 slices. Okay, and then WN. Yeah, how to calculate for the WN? Okay, you can refer to example 3. Yeah, here. Yeah. In the previous lecture, yeah, method of slices, example 3, yeah. So this is how you calculate for the WN. Yeah, you can refer back this one. Okay. All right. Okay, and then sine alpha N. Yeah. So the alpha here, yeah, the alpha N here, yeah, you have to refer to the previous example 3 lah. Yeah. So this is the alpha N. Yeah. Given in example 3. Yeah. So this is example 3. Yeah. You can this note I already upload in Google Classroom. Yeah. So you can refer here lah. Yeah, example 3. Yeah, so this is the alpha N. All right. 72 degrees slice number 2. Yeah, the alpha N equal to 59 yeah, degree. So you refer here. Okay. Then sine alpha. Yeah, for the first one, sine alpha 72. Yeah, you get here lah. Yeah, 0.951. Okay, and then cos alpha n yeah equal to this one lah. Yeah, alpha n just now is 72. Cos 72 equal to 0.309. Okay, and then un. What is un? How to calculate un? Un you have to refer here lah. Yeah, un equal to hn yeah gamma w yeah. So if you refer here yeah, for the slice number 1 there are no groundwater yeah, because the fitting line start from slice number 3 right. Okay, so that's why here is zero, because the h is zero lah. Is it clear student this one? Okay.
Yeah, clear.
Okay, it's good. All right. Then, same goes to number 2 lah. Yeah, slice number 2. Because there is no groundwater here. Okay. Now, slice number 3. Yeah. The H1 and H3 lah. Yeah, slice number 3, H3 equal to 1.96, 94 here. Yeah, sorry, here. Yeah, 1.94. So, to calculate for UN, yeah, UN for slice number 3 equal to 1.94 times 9.81. Gamma W is 9.81. So, you multiply 1.94 multiply by 9.81, then you get 9.52. Okay, here, all right. So you can do the rest, lah. Yeah. Yes. For slides, yes.
We cannot see the slide.
Oh, cannot see slide.
Yeah, yeah, I can see.
Okay, yeah, sorry. I can see. Why you didn't mention earlier?
No, we are okay. Working.
We are seeing, ma'am. We are seeing. That's absolutely right.
You cannot see my screen?
Yeah, we can see. Nice, my internet problem.
Oh, I see. So I should again. Because now I shared my entire screen. So if I change the slide or whatever on my screen, you should see the screen. Lah. You should see all, everything on my screen.
Yeah, yeah,
if you have. Okay. So we can see the screen now here.
Yes.
Please. Yeah.
All right. So do I need to repeat for UN here?
Yes, ma'am. Can you repeat UN?
Okay. For UN here, yeah, UN, yeah, is here. Yeah. So this is the equation for UN. Yeah, UN here. Yeah? UN equal to HNW, gamma W. Yeah, as I mentioned, HN is the height of the groundwater here. Yeah, so for slice number one and slice number two, there are no groundwater, right? Because the groundwater starts from here. This is the phatic line, meaning that the groundwater line. Okay, so that's why for the slice number one and slice number two, they are the UN is equal to zero lah, because the H is zero. You get me?
Yes, yes.
Is it clear? All right. Okay, and then for the slice number three, yeah. Okay, slice number three here. Yeah. So the H, yeah, H equal to 1.94 here. Yeah, the H. Right? So UN, yeah, equal to 1.94 multiplied by gamma W is 9.81. Yeah. So that's why you get here, yeah, 9.52. Okay, do you have the calculator with you? Then you can try to calculate. Eh?
Exactly same.
All right. Okay. So you do the same for the rest, lah. Okay. I think this one is clear, eh? To calculate for the UN. All right. Okay. And then for the LN, yeah. So for the LN equal to, yeah, B cos alpha B over cos alpha N. I think this one is in previous.
Yeah, BN by cos alpha N.
Yes, here, yeah? In a previous slide, yeah, it stated here. Yeah, here, LN equal to BN, this one, eh? BN over cos alpha N here. Eh? Okay, can you see my slide?
Yeah, it's clear.
Okay, so that is how you calculate for this one. Eh? All right, alpha LN. Okay, so the B, yeah, the width of the slice. Which of the slices mentioned here? Stated here, yeah? So, slice number one, the width is 0.6 meter, okay? And for the slice number two up to number seven, is stated here, notes here. The width of the slices for number two until number seven is 2.09, okay? So B is this one, yeah. B for slice number one, yeah. Slice number one, B is 0.6 divided by cos alpha here, 0.309. Okay, then you solve, you get delta LN and delta L1 because slice number one, yeah, equal to 1.942. Okay. Okay, next is clear up to here.
Yeah.
Okay. And then UN delta time multiplied by delta LN. So you for slice number one, UN is zero. Yeah, delta LN is 1.94. Okay, you multiply this one so you get zero. Okay, and do same for the rest. Yeah, calculate same for the rest lah. Okay, and then WN cos alpha N. This one is straight away. Yeah? So WN time cos alpha N. Yeah, so you get 5. And then WN sine WN here time sine alpha n, so you get 15.4. Okay, then Wn cos alpha n here 5. Yeah. Minus Un delta n here lah 0. Yeah. So 5 minus 0, then you get 5. Yeah. Okay. And then do same for the rest lah. Okay. And then you after you complete the table, all right. So you can solve, you can calculate for the Fs, yeah, Fs here, yeah, using this equation, lah. This one, yeah, okay, using this equation, so you have everything here. You calculated already, then you substitute everything into this equation, yeah, then you get Fn equal to approximately equal to 1.2, yeah, so the C prime is given in the equation, yeah, delta n here, yeah, 22 point here, delta ln here, yeah, summation of delta ln equal to 23.48, sorry, here, okay, and then summation of Wn cos alpha n minus Un delta n here, lah. Yeah, 1126.04, yeah, substitute here the value, and then tangent 20, yeah, friction angle given in the equation, yeah, this one, yeah, phi prime is 20, okay. And then Wn sine alpha n here. Yeah, summation of Wn sine alpha n is 735.23. Yeah, so you substitute everything, yeah, into here. Yeah, right, then you get the FOS. Okay, clear? For example number 4, example 4?
Yes, clear.
Okay.
Yeah,
all right, so any question? No, eh?
Yes.
If there's no further question, then okay, then we move to example and move to the next topic. I want to check whether okay, I record the lecture or not. Okay, so it's okay now. So we move to slide number 13. Okay. So solution for steady state CP, yeah? So Bishop and Morgenstern solution, all right? Now we move to Bishop and Morgenstern solution, okay? So Bishop and Morgenstern develop table for calculating, yeah, factor of safety of the simple slope using Bishop simplified method. Okay, the principles of this development can explain as follow, yeah. So Wn, yeah, equal to total weight of n number of slice, yeah. So equal to this equation, alright. So the Zn here, yeah? Here the Zn, oops. Too sensitive with the slide. Okay, so Zn here is here. Yeah, Zn is the average height of the slice. Okay, and then Un, yeah, explained before. Yeah, Un equal to Hn gamma W. Okay, and then you can, so we can let Ru, yeah, equal to this equation. All right. Okay. Let with average value of RUN BRU. Yeah, so most practical cases RU may range up to 0.5. Yeah, so FS, yeah, equal to this equation, right? Okay, and then factor of safety, yeah, factor of safety may express as here lah, this equation. Okay, and then RU equal to this equation lah, right? So M prime and N prime are stability coefficient which are given in table 15.5. Yeah, so here lah, right? You can get this table in your reference book. Okay. Okay, before I forget, I want to tell you, yeah, so in the exam, yeah, normally I will give open book exam lah, yeah, open book test. So I won't give you equation, so you can refer to the textbook for the equation and also all the tables lah. Yeah?
Yeah.
So you so you make sure you have the reference book. Yeah? So because I won't give you the table and equation. Yeah? So okay, you can refer in your textbook during examination. So make sure you have the reference book. All right?
Yeah.
Yeah, don't ask me during the exam for the equation and the table, because you can refer in the reference book. Yeah, make sure you have it before test. Huh? All right.
Yeah. All right.
Okay. Okay. So table 15.5. Yeah, give the value of M prime, and N prime. Yeah, for various combination. Yeah, here. Huh? Right, to determine FS, yeah, from the table here, where is the table? Here, table here, yeah. So you can use the following step. Okay, so I won't read this one. You can read yourself. Yeah, the step. I will show you the example. Yeah, using the steps listed here. All right. Okay, so for example 5, yeah, a given slope under steady state seepage, yeah, have the following. So h equal to 21.26 meter, yeah, friction angle, yeah, phi psi prime equal to 25 degree, yeah, slope. Yeah, so the slope, yeah, equal 2h to 1 V lah, yeah, 2 to 1, the angle. Okay, and then C prime, yeah, equal to 20 kilonewton per meter square, yeah, gamma, yeah, the density equal to 18.5 kilonewton per meter cube, yeah, RU, yeah, is 0.25. Okay, determine the factor of safety using table 15.5. So the question want us to use this table, right? Okay, so to solve this problem, you have to prepare the table same as this one. Okay, so first you have to calculate for beta. Yeah. So for beta, yeah, beta equal to tangent up 10, yeah, tangent minus 1 is, we call it up 10, equal 1 over 2. Yeah, so you solve this one, you get 26.57. Okay. So where you get this one? 1 over 2 ni is actually the
slope.
the slope angle here. Right? So this is your slope. Yeah. So one vertical, two horizontal. Terbalik. Correct. Ni. Okay. One vertical, two horizontal lah. Alright. Okay. So that's why you get here lah. Yeah. Beta here. Okay. And then C prime. And then you have to calculate for C prime over delta H. Yeah. So C prime given in the equation is 20. Yeah. Gamma also given in the equation. Yeah. Here. Yeah. 18.5. Yeah. And then H also given in the equation here. Yeah. Height of the slope is 21.62. Okay. Then you solve. Then you get 0.05. Yeah. So what is the purpose you calculate for that? Yeah. C prime ni, you want to choose which table that you're going to use. Huh? Yeah. Because now you have to find the M and N. M prime and N prime value. Okay. So the C prime over gamma H, yeah, equal to this now 0.05 lah. So you refer to this table, yeah, which the value is 0.05. Okay, because there are other value which is 0.25 and 0 here, which are 0.25 and 0 lah. Yeah, but in the example, you calculate for C prime over gamma H, yeah, the value is 0.05. Nah. So you refer to the table which have that value. Lah. Okay. Okay. And then the beta here is calculated here. Lah. Yeah, 26.75. Okay. And then the friction angle. Yeah, is given in the equation is 25 here. Yeah. Alright. Okay, and then C prime over delta H, yeah, given calculated here also. Yeah, 0.05. Okay, what is D? Yeah, so the value of D here. Yeah, you get from the table here. Yeah, if you can see from the table, man. So for table, which the value of C prime over delta H ni, yeah. So they have three table. So first table, the D is equal to 1. Yeah, and then next table, yeah, the D equal to 1.25. Yeah, and the third table, yeah, the D equal to 1.5. So that's why the value here, the D is what I mentioned just now. Lah. The D equal to 1 and 1.25 and 1.5 here. Okay? All right. Now, from the value that we have here, yeah, you can use this table, yeah, to get the M prime and N prime value. Lah. Okay. So for the first one, yeah, C prime delta over delta H equal to 0.05. Yeah. And then the D is equal to 1. Yeah. So the friction angle, yeah, the friction angle is 25 given in equation. Yeah, and the slope angle given in equation also, yeah, is 2 to 1. Yeah, here. In equation, the slope angle, yeah, 2 to 1. Yeah, 2 horizontal, 1 vertical. Alright. Sorry. So you use this one. So you use this table, lah. Okay. So, friction angle 25, yeah, then you get M prime equal to 1.356 and N prime equal to 0.282. Yeah. Kenapa tak sama? Share lah the value. 25, right? Here. Yeah? The value. Sama tak? Here, yeah? Here. Same value lah. Okay? Is it? You get... Do you understand? You get my explanation?
Yes.
Okay. And sorry.
Yeah. All right. All right.
Okay. So then you use the same method. Yeah. Refer to the next table lah. For D equal to 1.26 and D equal to 1.5 using this table. Yeah. So 25, yeah, the MN is here, M prime is here, N prime is here, yeah, for D equal to 1.25. Okay, and then next table, D equal to 1.5, so 20, friction angle 25, then you get the M prime and N prime equal to 1, here lah the value, yeah, this value, okay, you substitute the value into this equation. Alright, then you can calculate for this one lah. Yeah, so Fs equal to M prime, yeah, here M prime minus N prime times Ru. So Ru is given in equation here, yeah, 0.25. Alright, so you solve, then you get the factor of safety lah. Yeah, now you have three factor of safety, right? So, normally, yeah, when you design something, yeah, you will take the lowest FOS lah as your reference, the worst case. Yeah, so normally you use the smaller FOS lah. Yeah, when you design, you will use the smaller. You will refer to the smaller FOS lah. Yeah. So the FOS that you get here in this equation is point approximately equal to 1.29. Yeah. So for the safe side, normally we will refer to the smaller number of factor of safety lah. Yeah, the optimum one. All right. So clear. For example 5. Is it okay, Sudhir?
Yeah, ma'am.
All right. Okay, now is the last example. Yeah. Last method, which is pencil solution. Yeah. Let me bring water. Allow me to bring water first. Okay. So now we move to now we move to Spencer solution, yeah? So Bishop's simplified method of slices satisfy the equation of equilibrium with respect to the moment, yeah, but not respect to the force, yeah. So Spencer, yeah, in 1967, yeah, the researcher lah, yeah, has provided a method to determine a factor of safety by taking into account the interslice force. Yeah, which does satisfy the equation of equilibrium, yeah, with respect to moment and force. Yeah, so it's considered both moment and force. Yeah, So the detail of this method of analysis are beyond the scope of this text. Yeah. So how the mathematical solution, yeah, to get the equation is not in our scope lah. Yeah, we just use the equation that provided by Spencer. Okay, okay. All right. If you want to study further on the equation, so you can refer in a reference book lah. Okay. Or the paper that produced by Spencer to produce the equation. Okay, so in our lecture, yeah, as a geotechnical engineer, normally we just use the equation lah, yeah, all right. But if you have time, yeah, you want to learn further, you can refer, yeah, you can study how the Spencer come out with the equation, all right. And the final result of Spencer's work, yeah, are summarized in this section, 15.35, yeah. Note that RU, as shown in the figure, yeah, is the same as given in equation 15.62. So the RU equation just now is the same, yeah, here, all right. Now, in order to use the chart, yeah, given in the figure 15.35, yeah, to determine the required FOS, the following step by step produce procedure, yeah, need to be used. Okay, so there are a few six steps here, yeah, to calculate for FOS, yeah, to get the FOS based on Spencer method, yeah. I won't read one by one. Yeah, I will explain once we go further on the solution. All right, on the example. Okay, so we will follow step by step. Yeah, here to solve example six. All right. So for example six, yeah. Solve example five just now. Yeah, so example five here. Yeah, so the value we use the same lah, same value as example five. Yeah, but now we solve using Spencer solution. Okay, so to solve this one, yeah, using Spencer solution, you have to provide and prepare. You have to prepare this table first. Okay. So given h equal to given h equal to 21.62, yeah, this one is given in the equation, the height of the slope, yeah, 21.62, okay, beta yes, the beta here, yeah, you calculate just now in the solution here, eh? Okay, 26.57, sorry, okay, all right. And then C prime is given in the equation, and this one also delta given in equation, same goes to friction angle 25, and RU also given in equation 0.25, all right. So then you have to prepare this table. Okay. So to solve this one, you have to assume first. Yeah. Assume the FS, the factor of safety. Yeah. So this one beta. And the beta here, yeah, you calculated just now. So put here. Okay. And then FS, yeah, you have to assume this one. Okay. Normally, yeah, the FOS, as I mentioned earlier in a previous lecture, yeah, the slope considered stable, yeah, if the FOS more than one, yeah, if below, then you get the FOS below than one, meaning that the slope is not stable and the slope failure already should already occurred at that particular area. Yeah. So later on, yeah, when you are working, yeah, you do you involve in slope analysis, by example. Okay, you go to the site, all right, and the failure is already occurred. Okay, then you redesign, recheck the slope lah. Yeah. So the fail area, when you analyze, yeah, you should get the, normally you will get the FOS below than one lah. That's why the failure occurred. All right. Okay. So now when you assume for the, when you want to assume for the FOS, you should assume the FOS more than one lah. Yeah. So that's why you start the FOS start with 1.1 here. Yeah. So as I mentioned earlier, yeah, normally for the FOS, yeah, for the treated or man-made slope, yeah, the maximum FOS normally we will set up to 1.5. Yeah. If you actually, you can have more, the FOS more than 1.5, but if you put the higher FOS, then your structure, you know, your design is not optimum already. Yeah, because you have to if you design for the retaining wall, for example, you want to get the FOS more than 1.5, so maybe you have to increase the width of your wall, yeah, or the thickness of your base. Yeah, for example, this is your retaining wall, right? Yeah, if you design the FOS, yeah, more than 1.5, yeah, normally the client, yeah, will not happy lah with your design, because when you increase the FOS, yeah, you have to increase your design, the shape, yeah. So you have, maybe you have to increase the thickness of the wall or the thickness of the base, only then you can get more FOS. So your design will not optimize already lah. Yeah, so that's why normally we limit the FOS up to 1.5. You can have more, yeah, if you feel unsafe, yeah, or circumstances, you have a bad soil, by example, or the slope is the soil is really weak and there's a big crack, yeah, on top of the slope, so you want to increase, and in a certain skin cancers, you want to increase the FOS, you can do so, but normally, yeah, we limit the FOS up to 1.5. And in your design, yeah, sometimes it's hard to get 1.5 also, the FOS, but you have to design for that lah. Okay, I hope it's clear, eh, Sudin?
Yeah, ma'am.
So that's why here, yeah, the FOS, yeah, first they assume is 1.4, 1.2, 1.3 and 1.4. Or you can assume more, 1.5 by example, but in this example it's assume up to 1.4 only. Yeah, it's up to you as a designer, it's up to you what is the FOS value that you want to assume or you want to get. All right. Okay. And then next, you have to calculate for this equation. So C prime is given in the equation is 20. Yeah. FS, assume. Yeah. So here lah. Yeah. Substitute the value into this equation. And then the delta is 18.5. Yeah, and then the H is the height of the slope, yeah, is 21.26. Yeah, okay, I want you to know all the parameter, the parameter here stand for what lah. Yeah, because as a engineer, yeah, normally we will just use the symbol here, yeah, okay, but you have to know what is the symbol stands for lah. Yeah, okay, all right, so the H here is the height of the slope. Yeah, because if you do not know later on when you are working, you want to refer back this equation, then you don't know what is the H because it's not mentioned in the equation. Yeah, you have to find in the notes. So that's why you have to know. And normally in the exam also, yeah, sometimes I won't use the symbol. I will use the term. By example, I won't use the variable H here. I will mention the slope height. So you have to know the slope height is the H lah in the equation. Yeah, so that's why you have to know each of the symbol here is stand for what parameter, which parameter. Alright. Okay. Alright. Then you solve each of them. Yeah, you substitute all the parameter that you have up here and the factor of safety, then you get this value lah. All right. And then for this one, yeah, you can refer to this table. And this table, but this figure. Okay. So how to use this one? This figure. Okay. Just now you calculate for the slope angle kan? Ani? Beta ni is 26 kan? 26.57. So it's about here lah. Yeah? Okay. Tak straight pula. It's okay. Tak straight. The line is not straight. Tak apalah. More or less kan. So macam tu. Okay. It's about that. Alright. And then the C prime ni. C prime FS gamma H ni. Yeah, you get in the equation here lah. Yeah, 0.0 mana ni? 0.0455. Okay, so 0.0455 is about here lah. Oops. It's about here. Kurang lah. Betul ke ni? It's not here. I think ni 0.5. Let me. So you can refer to your reference book and try to solve and use a ruler. Is about here. Alright. Okay. Then it's refer to this line kan. So you project, then you get 18 here. Yeah. How to choose this table is depend on the RU here lah. Yeah. So the RU just now is given in the equation is 0.25. That's why we use this table. Okay, then you project, then you get 18. Yeah, so in the you get 18 here lah. Alright, then to calculate for the FS calculated, you use this equation lah. Alright, so tangent 3 prime is tangent 18 over tangent 18, then you get this value lah. Nah, ni. This one tangent phi prime ni is 25 ni, yeah. So tangent 25 over tangent 3D prime is 18. Yeah. So you get, you solve, then you get 1.435. Is it okay, student? Up to here?
Yes, ma'am. I have one question.
Yes.
About FS, we can choose ultimate 1.5. Up.
You mean FS assume?
Yeah, assume it's just limit to 1.5, or we can choose more than 1.5 as well.
You can choose more than 1.5, but if you choose more than 1.5, normally it's not optimum already.
Okay, okay, there's.
Okay.
Yes. So should we choose less than 1.5?
Yes, it's good if you choose one less than 1.5. But if you want to choose maximum 1.6, is okay, lah, I think.
Okay, okay.
If you set like 2 is too high.
Yeah, correct.
Yeah, yeah, okay.
But more than one should be.
Yes, you should, because the, as I mentioned, yeah, for the stable slope, therefore, S should more than one. So that's why you have to start with 1.1, yeah? Okay? More than one, lah. Right? Okay, yeah? I hope it's clear, yeah? Okay, now up to here, is it okay?
Yeah, absolutely okay.
All right. Then you can calculate for the rest, lah. You try to calculate for the rest, yeah? Here. I just show you one, lah. Yeah? The rest, the calculation is the same. Okay? You try first. All right? Then you should get the same value, lah. Inshallah,
yeah?
Yeah. Okay. All right. Okay, and then to solve this one, yeah, to get the value, yeah, the optimum value, yeah, for this one, you have to prepare the graph like this, yeah. So FOS assume, yeah, here lah. Start from one, as I mentioned, so start from one up to whatever value lah you want here. But because now the FS assume is 1.4, yeah, so you just up to, that's why the graph is up to 1.6 only, yeah. Okay, and then the FS calculated is the same, lah. Yeah, because here the FS calculated is up to 1.435 only, yeah, so that's why it's up to here, 1.6. All right, then you plot. Yeah, then you plot first 1.1. Yeah, the first point here is 1.1. Yeah, 1.1 and 1.43 is about here, lah. So that's why you get this point. Okay, and do for the rest, lah. 1.2 and then the value is 1.34. Here lah, 1.354. Yeah? And then this one also same lah, 1.3 and then 1.281. And same goes to here. Yeah, 1.4, 1.215 lah. Alright? Okay. Then after you have the point, okay, after you have the point, right, then you project me like this, okay, almost 1 o'clock already, okay, then you can have the line, okay, and then how to get the optimum, you have to draw 45 degree here, okay, then you project to the line that you get just now, this line, okay? Then you project here. Then you get the optimal FOS equal to 1.28. So that's how you use, that's how you solve the you calculate for this, you do the slope stability analysis solve using Spencer method lah. Yeah. Okay. So finish our example and our lecture also.
Madam.
Any question?
Yeah. Why we are 45 and 1.28 plotted? Is this the fifth angle? Like we have to only 45 like this?
Yes. Yes, because Spencer mentioned that is how they come up with the apa tu, the research kan, the research, then that is how they solve the problem lah. So they mentioned that you should get 45 degree, then you project, then you get the optimum.
Oh, all right.
Hmm. So that is how you solve using Spencer solution, lah. Right? Why 45? Then you have to read his research, lah. Why 45?
Yeah.
Okay. Okay. So you have to read further on that if you want to know. But for us, you can just use lah whatever value that he's provide to us. Okay.
Yeah.
So that's all for our lecture today. Yeah. So any other question? I hope it's clear. So yeah. I think we finish on the slope stability. So next week we will proceed in our next topic lah.
Okay.
If I have already the recorded lecture, I will give you the recorded lecture lah. If not, we will do the synchronized class like this. I think both is clear to you also, right?
Yes.
If you have further question, on my lecture, if I give you the recorded lecture, you can ask in a WhatsApp group lah. Yeah, please ask in a WhatsApp group. If you ask one by one, maybe I will miss your message because it's overwhelmed with all the messages from the student. Yeah, if you ask in a group, normally I will refer to the WhatsApp group lah. Yeah, okay. Only four of you. Where is Muaz? Just now he's here, right? Now missing.
He got disconnected.
He got what?
Maybe internet problem or got disconnected.
Yeah. It's okay. I will share this recording in Google Classroom so that you can refer again. Yeah. All right.
Thank you.
I think okay. If no further question, everyone already fill in the.